exploring the multiverse of pop culture.
This is Pod Casserole.
An Adam and JP show.
I get copping it, washing it, about to go and get some compliments, passing up on those moccasins. Someone else has been walking in, bummy and grungy fucking men. I am stunting and flossing and saving my money, and I'm hella happy that's a bargain, bitch. I'ma take your grandpa style, I'ma take your grandpa style. No, for real, ask your grandpa, can I have his hand me down?
Thank you.
Velour jumpsuit and some house slippers, Dookie Brown leather jacket that I found, dig it. They had a broken keyboard, I bought a broken keyboard. I bought a ski blanket, then I bought a kneeboard. Hello, hello, my ace man, my Miller. John Wayne ain't got nothing on my fringe game, hell no. I could take some pro wings, make them cool, sell those. The sneakerheads will be like,
ah, he got the Velcros.
I'm gonna pop some tags, only got $20 in my pocket. I'm hunting, looking for a come up. This is fucking awesome.
Ow.
I'm gonna pop some tags, only got $20 in my pocket. I'm hunting, looking for a come up. This is fucking awesome.
The 35th year of GPKs. You know, I still collect those.
Oh, tell me about it.
You know that. I give you pictures every now and then. You probably don't see them.
But I don't know that you collect them.
Oh, I'm still buying them.
I thought you just find them and then you just send me pictures.
You just find randos on the streets like it's 1989.
Yeah. It's like a real world Pokemon Go, but you're out searching for Garbage Pail Kids.
No, I still
bus stops.
Still buy them. Because they know suckers like me, they put out, like every, I would say quarterly, they put out a new, they have like I Love the 80s, I Love the 90s, some Hollywood, around, of course around Halloween they have the Horror-ibbles, which are like horror movie things.
Do they still like, they still based off current pop culture?
Yeah, well I mean, depends, but yeah, some can. Some are nostalgic.
Yeah.
Some are new.
Like is there a Trump Garbage Pail Kid?
I'm sure. I haven't seen it myself, but I'm sure it's there.
Donald J. Grump.
I'm sure. I'm sure it's a thing.
Yeah. Is there a Nancy Pelosi Garbage Pail Kid?
No. Oh yeah, there are tons of Donald Trump GPKs.
What's his name?
There's Donald Dumpty. He's like Humpty Dumpty.
Oh yeah.
With his head. Donald Dump. He's on the toilet.
Now some of these may go back to the 80s.
Dodgy Donald. Him with a wheelbarrow full of cash? Yeah, it's possible. These are great.
Is there an ex-president Donald Trump?
Temperamental Trump, him like blowing a gasket? These are funny. Wow, yeah, I like these. I can look for days. I'm a GPK fan.
That's good.
You like Donald Dump?
Old Donald Dump. So you want to talk about, because I mean, we just ended a decade.
Right, we didn't speak, so last week was all Star Wars heavy.
Yeah.
And we didn't speak much of our Christmas or our end of the year.
Didn't. We jumped right into the Star Wars.
I mean, it's, you know, it's Christmas.
Well, tell me about Christmas. What happened?
It's Christmas. We got some things. Went to Wisconsin.
How was that?
It was good.
How cold was it?
Actually, even the day we left, it was 55 degrees.
Really?
In Wisconsin.
It was like 70 here for Christmas.
Yeah. Wasn't that, they were confused up there. They'd never, of all the years I've been going there, like three or four or five in a row, it's been mounds of snow, and this was in the 50s. They were so shocked.
Well,
yeah.
Global warming.
Because Wisconsin, I mean, they'll tell you that themselves. It's a very, because there's so much melted rain and melted snow, and there's not snow there, it's a very ugly state.
Right.
I mean, they'll tell you that themselves. Everything's like dirty and muddy, and the cars are rusted. If you have that nice white blanket, it makes it nice, but if there's no snow, it just looks dingy.
It covers it up.
It does, yeah. Yeah. It's sad but true.
Well,
got some good cheese, though.
Well, I hope so.
Like a lot of cheese. Still eating the cheese. I got some ghost pepper spread.
Yeah?
Man.
Good?
I love it, but it's like instant sweat.
Really?
Yeah. Big fan.
Do you like horseradish at all?
Mm-mm. That's more of a flea. Like, I love spice, but that's on that...
it's hot.
Yeah, it's that like almost wasabi.
Yes, it is.
Like wasabi is... Next to vinegar, wasabi is my least favorite flavor in the world.
Really?
I despise vinegar. Like smelling it makes me gag.
Right.
But right below that's wasabi. If I have any kind of sushi and like a dink is on a rice kernel, so it's over. The whole tray's done. It's done.
What's underneath wasabi?
As far as food, like edibles?
Yeah.
That's a good question. Let me think about that. Those may be the only two. Hey, I'm pretty much a garbage disposal except for those two things.
Top three things you hate.
Mm,
catfish is in my top three.
Really?
Yeah.
Huh. I could down some catfish.
I don't like catfish.
Huh.
Really, just fish in general.
Yeah, you're not a fish fan.
No. I don't like the fish.
You know my meat. If it's walking, I'll give it a try.
Oh, I know. Well, or swim.
Yeah, if it's breathing, I'll give it a try.
Would you eat a human?
No.
I think you would.
I mean, if we had to. Like,
I think you would.
What's the movie called? What was it called?
The one about the plane crash?
Yeah, it was groundbreaking in the early 90s. Like the, yeah.
The cannibals?
Alive? What was it called?
Alive, yeah.
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 I kind of want to see that because when I was a kid, when that came out, it was like this taboo, forbidden movie. Like, you don't see that.
That's a great subject. I would like, because I was thinking along these lines the other day, is there a movie that you missed or you weren't allowed or something along those lines that came out when you were a kid that you still haven't gone back and watched today?
That's a good question. Because my parents were pretty lenient.
Right.
Even though for Alive, that was a no-go. Huh. I don't think, maybe Alive is the one.
Yeah.
Because in my head, it's this bad, it kind of has that Texas Chainsaw Massacre feel to it. Like, it was always told to me it was this terrible, you know, true story, brutal, gory movie, and you see TCM, and it's not even close to that.
Yeah.
It's not at all. So I'm curious if Alive is that bad. What about you?
That's tough, because I remember, like, in college, I tried to rent and watch all the movies that I wasn't allowed to see growing up. But is there one that... Oh, Bull Durham.
Really?
Yeah.
Hmm.
For some reason, my parents saw Bull Durham, wouldn't let me watch it, and then I've never gone back and watched Bull Durham.
Huh.
Yeah.
Is that a raunchy movie?
I mean, it's a baseball movie. It's Kevin Costner. I mean, how raunchy could it be? And
that's
Susan
true.
Sarandon.
That's true.
And Tim Robbins.
That's true.
I mean, it's not like it's a Larry Flint production.
That's true.
But yeah, Bull Durham. I've never seen Bull Durham.
Yeah. Huh. Yeah, I haven't either, but I didn't know that was like a... I didn't know it was risque.
Well, I don't know. I've never seen it. For some reason, my parents will let me watch it.
Yeah.
Could be language. I don't know. Do you remember the first R-rated movie you saw in the theater?
In the theater? Friday.
Yeah?
Yeah.
That's a good one.
I was young. 11?
Mm-hmm.
Come out 95, I believe.
Terminator 2, Judgment Day.
Mm. Good selection.
That's strong.
Good selection.
That's a strong good one.
That is, yeah.
Strong first one.
Yeah. Yeah.
Wait a minute. Was Thelma and Louise before Terminator 2? No, it was after.
No, I think that was like late 80s, right?
Thelma and Louise? No, it was in the 90s. It was like Brad Pitt's first.
I felt like 88.
Notable role.
Let's check it. You may be right. Was that rated R? And did you, wait, A, was it rated R? B, did you see it in theaters?
Yeah, I saw it at the drive-in. I saw Terminator 2 at the drive-in.
Okay.
Yeah.
There was something about the drive-in. It was more lean. 1991, so it was before T2.
Yes, it might have been Thelma and Louise.
That was your first R-rated movie. Was 91.
No, I want to say T2 was the first one.
Was it?
Yeah. T2 might have come out, because T2 was 91. It might have been right before Thelma and Louise. Might have been the same summer.
What a blockbuster summer for you.
Thelma and Louise, Terminator 2.
Yeah. Let's see here. That was 91. Let's see the actual release. And in the United States would be July 3rd, 1991.
Come on, Thelma and Louise. Be like August. Be like August.
That would be, May 24th.
Oh, Thelma and Louise was the first R-rated movie I saw. Maybe we got it late in Waverly, Tennessee.
Yeah, it's very possible.
Maybe we didn't get it until late in the summer.
The old dollar movies.
They used to do double features at that.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, wow. I saw Kill Bill Volume 1 and 2 at the drive-in, back to back.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. When Volume 2 came out.
I saw
a double feature.
Under Siege 1 and 2. The only drive-in experience I've ever had was with, what's his face?
Yeah. Oh, what is the name of the actress in Under Siege? She was on Baywatch.
Was that the,
Erica Aliniak. Yeah, or something like that.
Yeah. The classic, like, you know.
Yeah.
The scene.
That scene.
Yeah, yeah.
All those late 80s, early 90s movies had one.
Yeah, you
gotta
have one.
Even Die Hard.
You gotta have one.
Yeah, even Die Hard had a topless scene in it.
Yeah.
For no reason.
No.
Other than just to have one. RoboCop, same thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Funny story about RoboCop, speaking of Christmas, It happens every year in my family, but they go around and start telling stories. The majority of these we've heard for 30 years straight. Mm-hmm. Like, when Blank was younger, you should have seen this. I finally heard one I never knew. My uncle, when my sister was about 10 years old, RoboCop was in theaters. He takes her there. She got so messed up, she threw up right in the theater. The classic scene with they hit the guy in the car and he splats everywhere.
At least she made it to the end of the movie.
That's true, but she got so messed up.
How old was she?
I'll check when RoboCop came out.
RoboCop is a really hardcore movie.
So this is coming from my super hardcore Christian uncle taking his 10, 11-year-old niece. I was so confused.
Yeah.
I'm like, really? I thought maybe they got confused, but he's describing the scene of the toxic sludge hit by the car. It was beat for beat what happens in RoboCop.
Yeah.
He took her to see RoboCop in theaters and she vomited everywhere.
Because I would have been...
So it was 1987, so she would be 11 years old.
Yeah.
She was 11, watching an 11-year-old girl watching RoboCop.
And I was 12.
Yeah.
13, maybe, when RoboCop came out, and wanted to see it so bad. And I've told this story before. My dad would sometimes rent movies and do his edit that I could watch. And he did that with RoboCop. And I got through RoboCop in about 10 minutes.
Yeah. pretty fast. Yeah.
Same thing with the first time I saw Die Hard.
Yeah.
Yeah. There was a lot of Die Hard I didn't see the first time. Because he would try to catch words, too.
Yeah.
That's hard in Die Hard.
I'm sure, yeah.
And tough. RoboCop.
Yeah. The violence in the words. What else do you have? It's no movie.
Do we even have any movies that come out now that are even close to the level of violence of RoboCop?
Yeah. I think so. I mean,
such as?
Like Deadpool, that's pretty constant violence. And
that's true.
It's pretty hardcore, right?
Yeah.
Now, I haven't seen them, which I hear I would love them, but isn't John Wick pretty hardcore action heavy?
It's a lot of action.
Not so gory action, though.
But, I mean, yeah, that's the thing with RoboCop. It's pretty gory. Even Deadpool isn't as gory.
I mean, there are things chopped off and stabbings and fingers broken and floppy.
Just the comedy of it all that...
Yeah.
But, and even RoboCop is basically a parody, but it's of our, violence in our culture at the time, but...
I never saw that remake, did you? I couldn't bring
myself
to...
Yeah, I watched it.
Pretty bad.
Michael Keaton in it?
Was he in there?
Yeah.
Man, I couldn't bring myself to do it.
Yeah.
It just looked bad.
Yeah, well, and two, if you're gonna... Here's the thing, even RoboCop went... RoboCop was like an ultra-violent, hard R... NC-17, the first time it got put in front of the MPAA, then NC-17, and then they took enough out to get it to an R rating. But Paul Verhoeven is pretty, pretty hardcore film director.
You'd say that.
Yeah. It's the mind that brought you Showgirls.
Right. It's true.
And then RoboCop 2, I think, was still rated R, but wasn't on the level of violence, and RoboCop 3 was PG-13 because there were toys available. Trying to sell toys.
And video games, toys.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so I think when the remake of RoboCop came out with Carl Urban, it was, he was RoboCop, right?
Was he not?
Who was RoboCop?
I think he was.
I remember.
He was Dredd.
Yeah, he was Dredd. But it was PG-13.
Which I never saw that remake, by the way, either. I hear it was good, though.
Did you like the original Judge Dredd?
I mean, it's Stallone.
With Stallone?
Any movie. And I mean any movie he's in.
But you've never seen Cop Town, have you?
No, I haven't seen that one. No.
Yeah. But you have seen Stop or My Mom Will Shoot.
I have seen that.
You have seen Cobra.
I have parts of Cobra. I don't know why I haven't seen all of Cobra.
You have seen Death Race 2000.
I've seen Death Race. He's Frankenstein. He's great. Uh-huh. I'm trying to see the remake. Oh, 2014. It's been 6 years since that already.
Yeah.
Good Lord.
Yeah, I watched it on DVD.
Joel Kinnaman.
Yep.
Well,
they're doing another one.
Really?
They're doing another RoboCop reboot.
Hmm.
It wasn't terrible, but it wasn't great.
Yeah, I don't want to see it.
That's weird that your sister got taken so young.
Yeah.
To see RoboCop.
And just whistled carrots right in the theater.
Yeah.
Blah, right there.
Help me.
Oh, the guy that played, he was Rick Flagg in Suicide Squad. That was RoboCop.
Mm-hmm.
Would never recognize him.
Well, he's RoboCop.
Yeah, that's true.
He's wearing a visor the whole time.
That's true. But the decade has ended.
The 2010s are over.
Yeah. I'm glad we can use a word now, like the 20, like the 20s. We're in the 20s.
Yeah, we're in the 20s.
Never like the noughts, the teens, the tens, whatever. It's kind of like that.
Did you say noughts or aughts?
I meant to say aughts. That's what I meant to say. But it's just confusing. Now, after 20 years, we're back with a name.
I think historically, 2000 to 2010 is kind of going to go down as a lost decade.
Think so?
Yeah. I mean, because 9/11 happened in 2001.
Yeah.
Pretty much ruined the decade.
That's true, yeah. I can't think of like, you know, when you think of 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s, they all have their own style and culture and music and things. But yeah. You're right, the 2000s are kind of like...
Well, the iPhone.
Yeah, but like as far as culture, like a wardrobe, is it so dated? I don't know. Maybe if I look back, I would see that. But
probably, yeah.
I can't put a thing.
Especially like, early 2000s, because it looked just like the 90s.
Okay, we can describe it like the 50s. You'd have your poodle skirt or a greaser shirt with some Converse and a rolled up sleeve.
By 55,
right? Yeah.
In the early, see, it's always like you're going middle of the decade.
Yeah, but you're thinking
so think like 2006, 2007.
Yeah.
That's where you want to...
But I'm thinking like 60s, you have your hippie-ish kind of thing. 70s, more disco bell bottoms. 80s, neon, big hair. 90s, a little more grungy sometimes. What happens in the 2000s? What's the wardrobe of a 2000s person?
Earth tones?
I don't know. Just kind of
I wore t-shirts and jeans, so...
Yeah. I guess that was the beginning, because you have to look at these cool people.
Uh-huh.
I'm sure there are people in the 1988 wearing... a Pepsi shirt and jeans, but you think of the 80s, you think of like neon workout clothes and the crazy right. stuff. So
what were the cool kids
like
wearing?
Like the hipster stuff, like
what
skinny jeans.
What was Lady Gaga wearing in the mid-2000s?
I think it's when the hipster revolution started, like the skinny jeans, the wide-brim hats.
Oh, yeah, definitely
right?
Like a bowler hat.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Or is that in the 2010s?
Well, I think 2010s is more the skinny jeans and the...
You think so?
Yeah. So, because it's kind of today,
still,
right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Plaid's back.
Plaid is back, yeah.
Yeah. Here we are on the cusp of a new decade, and you thought it would be fun to go back and just kind of review the 2010s.
Yeah, yeah.
Like our favorite.
Just favorite media, we'll say. And I was going to do music, but that's too vast.
Yeah.
And it's too opinionated. But I do have some movies and some games to talk about.
Okay.
What do you want first, movies or games?
Let's do movies.
And these are, I'm not saying my favorite, but looking back had an impact on me and I thought did great things for cinema, film, and theater. And you'll have stuff from popcorn movies to artsies that you may not have heard of. So hang with me.
I doubt there's going to be as many of those on your
list.
No,
really, we have some. You can't deny when the Avengers came out in 2012. I mean, it was a huge event, right? I mean... And think about that. We thought at the time that was like the end-all, be-all, the pinnacle of it. But that was only 4 years into the actual MCU. Think about that. Only a four-year build-up.
Yeah, I think probably the MCU was the defining movie... what's the word I'm looking for?
Revolution?
I guess that's a good one.
Yeah.
Of the 2010s.
Yeah.
It definitely was the decade of... comic book cinema.
Yeah.
For sure.
And I don't know if anything in our lifetime will ever do that again. Can't replicate it.
But did it start with the MCU, or do you think the Nolan Batman movies had something to do with that?
No, don't give that much credit. No.
Really? The Dark Knight?
Yeah, I mean, it was good, but nothing like, not this epic. Not even close. We're talking like an amalgamation of 10, 15, 20 characters of years of storylines. It's not close to a great performance by Heath Ledger, which we're not taking away from.
Like sparking the interest in comic book films. You don't think Batman did it in the mid-2000s?
I don't think so, because I think I think Spider-Man, as far as sparking that comic book love, was much, I think that was...
Like the Amazing Spider-Man movies?
No. Like the Tobey Maguire.
Tobey Maguire.
Yeah,
that's fair.
I think so. Yeah. And even before that, like, do you remember how big X-Men was when it came out? Like, I was obsessed.
Yeah, that's true.
That was a huge deal.
But
huge.
Nothing like the MCU.
Correct, yeah.
Dominated cinema in the 2010s.
And so we're going to hop around here for me personally. Did you want to say one, or how do you want to do this?
No.
Okay, you can't talk about the Avengers with the, as of right now, the wrap-up to that, and Avengers Endgame. We've spoken of some last week. I mean, that's top of the top, right? It's pretty awesome.
Absolutely.
Like, to this day, the highest grossing movie in theaters of all time, globally, has to mean something.
Probably my favorite movie of last year.
Yeah.
Was Avengers Endgame.
It was good.
And a nice, And you know, and as we sit here and we had the Spider-Man movie, but we really haven't had anything from the MCU since Spider-Man, right? It hasn't been one since then.
Right, yeah, no.
And I'm almost like, you know what? I'm okay with that.
Yeah, you're content?
I am content.
Yeah, like I don't...
Like if it ended, if that's how it ended, and we, you know, didn't get an MCU movie for years, I'm fine with that.
Right.
I am kind of... I do want to see the next Guardians movie, but...
Yeah, I see what's coming down the turnpike, and I'm not hyped at all.
Because I think it's just going to be so hard to have something that special again.
Yeah.
It's not going to happen.
They shouldn't have ended that. Shouldn't have happened.
I mean...
It shouldn't have.
But think about how good the ending was.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But don't you want more? Want more good stuff?
Yeah. But I don't think we're going to get it.
I know that's the problem, yeah. I would say stretch that out longer. Make that, you know.
But that, I mean, that was a good ending, though.
I agree, yeah.
That was strong.
I know, I'm just being selfish. I want more.
The Cap ending was good. The Iron Man ending was good.
Nothing like I see the Black Widow trailer. I'm like, oh, man. Yeah. I'm not even kind of excited for this.
The Immortals?
That's the first, yeah. Shang-Chi, Chi-Chai, whatever. Chai-Ti. I don't know. I haven't had that lack of excitement in a long time.
You know, I think the 2010s also marked the, and you're going to hate this, but that's okay because this is a discussion. It really marked the evolution or dawn, I guess, of the PG-13 horror films.
Yeah, it did. I have some good ones on here, rated R, we can talk about.
Yeah, but like the Paranormal Activities and the Conjuring films and the Annabelle. All PG-13 horror movies.
Yeah, they were.
Blumhouse.
Right.
A21.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, but on the other avenue of that, the resurgence of a proper R-rated horror movie as well, such as Halloween.
Yeah.
And, of course, It.
Right.
Have you seen It 2 yet?
No.
Yeah.
I haven't seen it.
Was not a fan.
I haven't seen Joker yet either.
I wasn't a fan of It 2.
Love
the first one, but 2, something was missing. Something happened. You still haven't seen Halloween, have you?
No, I haven't seen Halloween.
Oh, man.
I'm slacking, man.
Didn't those bring my top 20 movies of all time? I think they did.
I think they did, too.
And I'll stand by
it. I guess
like,
that shows you how much faith I put into your top 20.
No, I'll stand by it. Those are fantastic, just the way they're done. Yeah, Halloween and It. Give me faith in some modern horror again. It really did. Some R-rated, thoughtful horror. It happened.
I don't think you can talk about 2010 cinema without just recognizing the dominance of Disney.
Right.
On many fronts.
Mm-hmm.
From Star Wars to MCU to their live-action version of classic animated fare. Like Beauty and the Beast. Lion King.
I saw, I believe it was the 6th, The Rise of Skywalker was the 6th Disney movie this year to break $1 billion.
I could see that.
That's insane.
I could see that.
On average, once every 2 months, you have a movie from your company breaking $1 billion. Imagine that money.
Yeah.
Imagine it.
Yeah, Disney. Pretty much taking over the world.
I mean,
between 2010 and 2020.
But is that a problem? Like you spoke of how much you love Endgame. The parks are doing great things.
No, I love it.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm very torn that I love a corporation so much, but I do.
But they're doing good things. I mean, it's fine by me.
Yeah.
It's not like it's Yahoo took the world over and we're like, oh, God.
When you look at like between 2000 and 2010 and you look at some of the franchises that began there, like Harry Potter, Lord of the Rings, and they all kind of wrapped up in the early 2010s.
True. Yeah.
Because the last two Harry Potter movies? 2011? Was it 2011? And 2012?
Was it? Not sure.
And what I believe to be some of the better Harry Potter movies.
Yeah.
Were the last ones. What's your favorite one?
I was hardcore into those first ones, so maybe... So my favorite book is Goblet of Fire.
Yeah.
But I think Prisoner of Azkaban is my favorite movie.
I was going to say Prisoner of Azkaban is my favorite Harry Potter movie.
Yeah, I think so.
It is.
Huh.
What else?
We spoke of it a lot last week, so I won't dog it too much. But, I mean, I can't have my own list without, of course, The Force Awakens and Rise of Skywalker on there. Those are my huge moments for cinema and me in the past decade. Just the moment of seeing those were big deals for me.
Is it too early to point to one movie and say that might have been your favorite movie of the 2010s?
I think it's too early, maybe.
Yeah.
But as of right now, it's Rise of Skywalker. maybe, I think, give me some time to soak on that.
I'm surprised the Twilight movies didn't make your list. Weren't those in the 2010s?
The later ones were, yes.
Yeah.
But those weren't the good ones. Only one and two were good. You know this.
When did the first one come out?
2008.
Was it?
Yeah. Oh. Yeah. And thanks for calling me out like that.
Well,
thank you.
I mean,
hey, once he brings back honor to the cow, people are coming back to me for some Sparkle Vampire. Go, did you wait?
Okay.
They'll be like, oh, let's watch some Robert Pattinson before he did this. He was so artistic. It's going to happen. Just you wait. Just you wait.
I think the Transformers franchise would be a big story of the 2010s.
Yeah.
There seemed to be a lot of Transformers movies in that decade.
So that's when I stopped watching them. I only saw the first two, which were 2007, I believe 2009. But after that, I haven't seen the newer ones. Yeah. But they're still popping
around.
Not
even Bumblebee.
Yeah, right.
I think The Rock became a huge movie star in the 2010s.
Yeah.
I think that's another big story.
Like, he's kind of the Midas. I mean, at first he was a joke. He was the Scorpion King. And he goes on to be...
And that goes back to the 90s.
Right, yeah. And he goes on and does many terrible movies.
Yeah. Between 2000 and 2010.
What's the turnaround for The Rock in that decade? What happened? What was the one movie where, A, it made some money and people were like, oh, he's not terrible?
What's the one where he was the... He was the football player with the daughter.
Was that Game Plan?
No.
There's a movie called Game Plan.
Is it the Tooth Fairy?
Or is it the Pacifier? Is that Vin Diesel?
That's Vin Diesel.
Is it the Tooth Fairy? What's the Game Plan?
I think the Game Plan was a more serious movie, right?
Was it?
Maybe not. Right around in there, I think. Race to Witch Mountain. I think that was another one.
You think so?
Yeah. Started the I think that definitely started his.
I think this is what you're thinking of. He was a football player and had the daughter. The Game Plan.
Oh, I guess it is the Game Plan. Yeah,
I never saw it.
Is it the one where he was the Tooth Fairy? Dwayne the Rock Johnson is the Tooth Fairy.
I think so. What is the Pacifier?
That's Vin Diesel. He's a babysitter,
like Mr. Nanny,
with Hulk Hogan. Yes. Yeah.
So there's Tooth Fairy Rock. I don't know. Yeah. I don't think either of those movies were his turning point. Let's say that.
What do you think it was?
I don't know. We should do it like...
Because by the time he did Jumanji, he was a huge star.
Right. Not tonight, of course. We should do eventually the complete works of The Rock. I mean, he has some movies, right?
Well, pull up his IMDb
page. It's right here.
Page.
Are you ready for it?
Yeah.
Oh, man, we're going to do a wrap-up of the 2010s. Now we're on The Rock's filmography.
Well, just do like, start at like 2006.
You have, don't forget Doom in 2005, though. And Be Cool, that was kind of a thing for him in 2005. 2006, Southland Tales and Gridiron Gang.
Okay.
Then you have Reno 911 Miami,
uh-huh.
The Game Plan,
uh-huh.
Get Smart, Race to Witch Mountain, Planet 51, Tooth Fairy.
Tooth Fairy! That was his turnaround.
In 2010, I don't think...
No, I think it was a big deal. He was in Get Smart, too.
The Other Guys, You Again, Faster... I guess Fast Five. Was it when we got into the... I think it's when he got into Fast and Furious.
I think he was a huge star by Fast Five.
Snitch. Maybe G.I. Joe Retaliation when he was Roadblock.
No. I'm going with Tooth Fairy.
No, I think Fast Five. Like, I don't like these movies, but I think it's Fast Five. And he's been part of that franchise for 9 years now. Mm-hmm. Pain and Gain, Fast and Furious 6, Empire State, Hercules, Furious San Andreas.
I think...
Of course, Moana. You have the Disney name. It's a big deal.
You're welcome.
Right, yeah.
Moana.
Exactly, yeah.
I think the Pirates of the Caribbean films were a big deal in the 2010s.
Yeah. Still not seen one of those.
Really?
Yeah.
Hmm.
Not one.
Hunger Games.
Yeah.
Big deal in the 2010s.
Yeah.
But what would be, if I had to pick out three favorite films from the 2010s? Endgame's way up there.
Yeah.
You know what? I'm going to pick Endgame or Infinity War. So I'll go with Endgame.
Mm-hmm.
I
still haven't spoken of Creed yet. I have to speak of Creed.
Oh, talk about Creed. Well, I think about my other two.
Creed's good.
Now back to you.
Came out in 2015. I loved it. Still love it to this day.
I really enjoyed Inception. Was Inception in the 2010s?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And Interstellar is actually on my list.
Oh, Interstellar is really good. That is really good.
That's one of those. Yeah, it got me thinking.
Yeah. It's a thinking man's movie.
Creed and then Interstellar. That's back to back.
I haven't seen Creed 2 yet.
Are you serious? What did you...
I know, I'm working on
it. Return of Ivan Drago and you're...
Yeah, I don't know.
What?
I don't know how I feel about the Return of Ivan Drago.
Oh, yeah, I forgot you're a hater of good things coming back. I forget.
Like,
you think he just shoehorned in last minute? Like, let's just bring in Drago. He wasn't on the Russian planet of Exegol hanging out. Just going to throw him back in there. Once again, give me a checklist. Adam, would you like Ivan Drago to return? Hell yes, I do. Please give me some more Drago, please. It's a simple equation.
Is Mr. T in this one?
No.
Yeah, okay.
You know, he doesn't get along with most people. Whiplash. I have Whiplash on there.
Oh, Whiplash.
So good.
Is on my list of films to see.
Man, what happened here? You used to be the movie man.
I know, Adam.
I'm seeing more artsies than you are now. What is
really
going on?
You really are. But you won't see Knives Out.
It's got the RG attached
to it.
It's
not even an art film.
I think last time we spoke and recorded, I was giving beef to this director. Deservedly so, though. I still stand by that. But you asked, had I seen any of his movies? And I gave, for some reason, this one didn't even register. But I love The Wolf of Wall Street by Scorsese.
Oh, yeah.
Love that movie. Very good.
2010's film.
Right, yeah, yeah. Last on my list, I thought was a... Now, the movie itself, honestly, is kind of boring. But the concept of it, of Boyhood. Did you ever see Boyhood? That's the one where they...
I haven't seen it.
Started filming
right.
in real time when he was 5 years old, and every summer they would film some for the story with the same actors, the same cast, until he was 18 years old. And so at the beginning of the movie, this boy is 5 years old. At the very end, the exact same actor is 18. It's insane.
Oh, that's crazy.
I mean, his parents, his siblings, everyone ages and changes with him. Once again, the story, I believe they kind of made it up as they went each summer. And the actor himself, I think, was picked for the way he looked and his visuals, not so much his acting chops. But it goes through the actual story of Boyhood. If you haven't checked it out, watch that movie. 13-year progression.
Is it the... who's the director?
Is that Richard Linklater?
Yes.
Yeah.
He's doing the same thing now.
Really?
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
There's not, and it's not a continuation of that,
uh-huh.
but he's the same concept.
Because he would, you know, of course, through 13 years, did many other projects, but... I think 2 weeks out of the summer, we just grab some footage.
Yeah.
Fantastic idea. This is great.
How
do you even get funding for that? How do you have someone back you for 13 years with the promise of a an end goal?
I don't think there's a lot of funding for that.
You don't think so?
I think you're making it on a shoestring budget.
Right, yeah.
I'm trying to think. Movies from the 2010s that aren't comic book.
It's tough, right?
Skyfall.
Yeah.
I really enjoyed Skyfall.
You know, I've still to this day not seen one Bond movie.
Mission Impossible Rogue Nation.
Never seen one Mission Impossible movie.
I think I would really like The Irishman, but I haven't seen it yet.
Yeah. Yeah.
Let's see. I think Black Panther was a fantastic movie.
It was good, yeah.
Even though it's an MCU film.
Mm-hmm.
That would be on my list.
Don't be ashamed of top ones. Being MCU.
Oh, Creed is definitely on my list. Yeah. Creed is definitely on my list.
Like that Ryan Coogler directing, pretty top notch.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah. I mean, speaking of Panther.
Yeah, and Creed.
Yeah.
The connection there.
Right.
And
you ever seen, I mean, we've talked about it, how young he is. He's younger than I am. It's depressing.
How old is Taika Waititi?
If I had to guess, close to 50, right? I'll look it up here, but I would think, I'm going to guess 49. What's your guess?
I'd say 45.
44.
Oh, wow.
It's that, like, he's been great for so long, it threw me off.
What about TV? I mean, 2010's definitely the new golden age of television.
Of the streaming
Because of
show.
How we, our consumption changed.
Right, yeah. If you had to guess just right now, what would your favorite show of the 2010s B, have you...
Though technically started in the 2000s.
Okay.
Breaking Bad.
Okay.
I think Breaking Bad.
Without thinking more, but the top of my head says Stranger Things for me.
Oh, Stranger Things is good.
Yeah.
It's definitely in my top five.
Like, I enjoy that. Whenever it comes out, I'm hyped, I'm ready, I binge. Yeah.
Though I was not into Game of Thrones. And that could have been the show of the decade.
Yeah, that was huge.
You watched the first couple of seasons, right?
Yeah, first two. Kind of lost that after a while.
You were like super fan when it first came on.
It was,
you brought over a chart that showed me like where all the families came from.
Yeah.
You loved it.
Yeah, it was just it was too much of a revolving door for me to be into that, you know.
Yeah.
Imagine having an MCU movie and the whole storyline, but every person you even slightly become attached to is killed off.
For me,
very few stuck around, very few.
Early in the 2010s is when I got caught up on the current revival of Doctor Who.
Oh yeah, you did. Yeah.
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 So even though technically I guess
wow. And that has faded out. That
was like 2005 maybe. That 2006. Flame is
dead, isn't it? I kind of forget that was even a thing.
Yeah, I mean, you don't hear much about it, but it was pretty
was,
popular. Yeah,
every con went to it was covered.
Yeah.
But now you don't see anything.
Like a lot of the Doctor Who conventions.
Right.
Went away.
Right?
Yeah.
Huh. It was the Matt Smith. I mean, people loved it for him.
Yeah, they kind of struck gold twice.
Yeah. Yeah.
With the, was it the 10th and 11th Doctors?
Yeah.
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 So,
yeah, we like young, hip doctors. Let's bring in Capaldi and just ruin it. Good idea. Was it Moffat doing it?
No, I enjoyed Peter Capaldi as the Doctor.
Yeah. I mean, everyone else did not, apparently.
Apparently not. I was in the minority.
Yeah.
What other TV shows? Were there any comedies? Were there any comedies that you watch? TV comedies.
Some bring backs. We had some Fuller House. We had some Roseanne / the Conners.
Oh, I do like the Conners.
Right.
I like Superstore.
Yeah.
I think that's good.
Yeah.
Any of the like Netflix comedies that you watch? Like BoJack Horseman? Or
I've tried that. I can't.
Can't get into it?
I.
Oh, Rick and Morty for me.
See, I don't.
Rick and Morty. But that wasn't Netflix.
Trying to think if I'm going to contradict myself. I can't get into animation. Like, yeah, I can't do it.
Except South Park.
If you want to count that, I guess.
Like, you're still going strong.
That's true, yeah. But I guess besides that, but never been a Simpsons guy. Rick and Morty's tough for me. I don't know.
Has South Park hit its 20th season yet?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. I remember in the sixth grade, which would be 1996, I was watching it, so.
Wow.
So it's 23, 24 seasons now.
That's like Simpsons numbers.
Yeah, well, they're past 30 now, right? So, yeah.
Are they going to call it quits? Have they announced that they're going to
I think, isn't last year the final one?
Is it?
I think so.
This year or last year?
It will be this year, because I think last year they said next year. Yeah. I believe so, yeah.
It's always the next year.
Yeah.
Who
would have thought, huh? We see a lot of, in the 2010s, speaking of those shows, we'll come back to, like, sitcoms, but you're a big fan of late-night talk shows. At least you used to be when you could stay up for them.
Yeah, that's true.
But we used to like those shows. We saw the, the exit of some big ones, right?
I mean, David Letterman?
Yeah.
The Conan thing happened in the 2000s, where he was at TBS.
10 years ago? No, he's not been on TBS for 10 years, has he?
So.
No.
Yeah.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
I haven't watched Conan in 10 years.
He's been on TBS as long as he was on NBC.
Wow.
Right?
Are you sure?
No.
I don't think
because he started in 1992, and then he went to the Tonight Show in 2000 and what was it? It was like 2008, right?
I'll look it up. I feel like it hasn't been 10 years.
I know we weren't living in this house.
Surely I've watched Conan because I've never ever seen him on TBS ever.
Yeah,
I've watched Conan once in the past 10 years, right?
Maybe on Netflix, Conan Beyond Borders.
No.
Not even his Comic-Con specials.
No.
Yeah.
Okay, so it premiered November 8th, 2010. So I mean, it's still much longer, but that happened. It's 2010s. That's still much longer than I thought. This would be the 10th year. Good Lord.
Jay Leno retired.
Right,
again.
Yeah. I cannot believe. Wow.
I don't really have a late night show that I watch a lot of. I know you are a big Jimmy Fallon fan.
Yeah.
I don't really watch The Tonight Show with Jimmy Fallon.
But he has this.
That often.
The format, much like James Corden. It's like a Netflix clip highlight. It's James Corden's is carpool karaoke. That's the biggest thing of his show.
Yeah.
Much like Fallon just has like those 4 to 5 minute clips. Mm-hmm. I think they get the most of their money from YouTube clips, honestly. They really do.
Never watched Jimmy Kimmel that much.
Yeah, he's so-so. Mm-hmm. I did not know. January 22nd, 2019, the Conan show went to a half hour.
Yeah. Ooh. I did know that. And one guest.
Oof.
One guest for half hour.
Really?
Yeah.
That's rough.
And the set's totally different now.
Really?
I don't think the band's there.
Mm.
It's just him and a couple of chairs. It's basically between two ferns.
He deserves better, right?
You
don't think so?
Yes. I love Conan. But I think it was by design because they dropped the format back to 30 minutes, but they're doing more Conan content. Like Conan Beyond Borders or Without or Beyond than the podcast. So there's more Conan stuff going on.
Mm-hmm.
It's just not a 1 hour, three guest talk show every night now. So
kind of sad.
In some ways, it's smart.
Yeah.
Oh, The Office.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
The Office was a big show for
people
me. And
that.
Parks and Rec.
Yeah.
Two big shows for me in the 2010s.
But the...
I don't like either one.
No, I like Parks and Rec.
Yeah?
I do love that.
I like Parks and Rec.
Yeah, yeah. I don't like The Office. Parks and Rec I do like. Big fan. Big fan.
Any other comedies on TV? Or just TV in general?
I mean, you have to talk about the Netflix, like the Marvel streaming shows. Those are huge.
Oh, yeah.
At least the first season.
Daredevil.
The first season of each of those were magical.
Mm-hmm.
After that, something happened.
I think season two of Daredevil was really good.
Yeah.
Because it introduced the Punisher.
That was it, yeah. But I think when Iron Fist came along.
It killed it.
Something happened
it
to me.
It killed it, didn't it?
I had zero interest in Luke Cage. Like, and
did you ever watch The Defenders?
No.
I never watched The Defenders.
That's so weird because that I was hyped for that for a year.
Yeah.
Remember the Nirvana, like the Come As You Are, like, yeah, all right.
Where it's just the narration by Styx?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I never watched 1 second of it. That's so funny.
Yeah, I never watched The Defenders.
So Jessica Jones and Luke, all that.
Didn't watch the last season of Daredevil. Didn't watch the second season of Jessica Jones.
Same. That's
didn't
funny.
Didn't watch the second season of Luke Cage.
No. And that had to be what happened. They all just like, of course, the Disney Plus merger happened as well. But I think before that, they were all getting canceled. Boom, boom, boom.
Yeah.
It had to be, I blame Iron Fist.
I don't think you're wrong.
It was terrible, right?
You killed it.
And those other ones were great.
You killed it.
So good. Should we hop to video games?
Well, before we do, I do want to mention that for me and you especially, 2000 to 2010, very pro wrestling heavy.
Oh, yeah.
Very WWE heavy.
Yeah.
Not so much between 2000 and 2010. Yeah.
And I ask myself this every few years, is the product changing or are we? Which one is it?
I don't know. I mean, I dropped out. And then came back, you know, from
yeah, it's
when
always
I watched
a cycle.
It when I was a kid.
Right now I'm in the off cycle.
Yeah. I mean, it's not that I don't want to watch it. I don't know. And
I'll
pop it over and watch it every now and then. But yeah, it's not like on my radar and something I look forward to every Monday night.
It used to be a religious experience for us.
But for us, it was also a communal experience.
That's true.
Which
yeah.
added to it. Mm-hmm. It was us, like a big group watching it together.
Yeah.
It was our Monday night football.
That's true. So cool.
There is no off season in pro wrestling.
I am excited the current state of wrestling. I think now is a good time to be a wrestling fan. You have many, many options. Ooh.
I like All Elite.
Yeah. Yeah.
What I've seen.
Yeah. Yeah. Have you watched NWA Power yet with 3 R's?
The YouTube show?
Yeah.
It's
actually good. It brings you back to the studio,
yes.
Like Mid-South, Memphis kind of wrestling.
Josh and Brooke showed me some of that on Christmas Eve.
Yeah. I'm actually a fan.
Yeah. I enjoyed it.
I mean, someone in the crowd, like cutting a promo to someone in the crowd, and
yeah.
You hear some redneck chewing him out.
I do love that whole live studio
yeah.
feel of that.
That's good stuff.
Back to old school wrestling.
Yeah.
Black and white wrestling. Video games.
All right. Let's just talk about the elephant in the room.
Okay.
Grand Theft Auto 5.
Yep.
Which now has been 7 years ago.
Yep.
How do you feel about that?
I want to get on and play the casino.
You should.
Yeah.
It's so odd to me. So Grand Theft Auto 5 comes out on the PlayStation 3 and Xbox 360 generation. So that means this whole generation of gaming, which will end here in less than a year, is went the whole generation without a Grand Theft Auto game. We had the port of 5, but that was meant for the old cons.
Yeah.
Isn't that strange? That's so weird. Like, does Rockstar put that much time and money for where a whole generation of gaming is skipped for their installment?
But, yes, there hasn't been a fresh game.
Yeah.
But.
So much content, and they've put Red Dead Redemption 2 out, which we'll talk about.
But that GTA world is alive and well.
Yeah.
And there is new stuff going on.
I know.
There just hasn't been a full-on game. And there may never be again.
Wow. You don't think so?
I mean, why would they?
They have to have a GTA 6.
Aren't there in-game transactions, like real money transactions going on?
Oh, yeah. Tons.
So.
Tons.
Why?
But you can't port that to the Xbox, whatever, or the PS, whatever.
The online?
Well, like,
they'll find a way.
Like, re-release Grand Theft Auto 5 again for the third generation?
No, they'll find a way to bring
Ooh.
Wow. It's getting late.
It is, yeah.
To bring that online community over to the next generation. It'll happen.
But GTA 5. Yeah. Now, 4, of course, was the end of the 2000s, but do you think, I mean, Trevor is one of the greatest characters of all time, right?
Hands down.
Right? I mean, for real.
Yeah.
He's that guy you want to be, like you could never, you know, people always say that video games don't cause violence because, or they do cause violence because you want to simulate what you see on screen. I've always been the guy like, no, that's stupid. Until I met Trevor. I'm like, huh.
I could see an influence
there. You know, it would be fun to get in my whitey tidies and crash a helicopter into a hotel. I won't lie about that.
Like in real life? Yeah. Seems painful. I'm going to be honest.
We're talking about that. The first time I saw from the skyscrapers, I saw the city of Arkham City over the shoulder of Batman. That was a moment in gaming I will never forget. So Arkham City has to be on my list for the greatest games, like the ones that meant the most to me, had the impact.
I think it was really the decade of story-driven games, too.
That's true. They stepped their game up. Speaking of that, I know you haven't played it, but please play it. Please play The Last of Us.
I was about to say The Last of Us.
I'm begging you. Like, it's...
Isn't the sequel about to come out?
Yeah, yeah. And so The Last of Us was 2012, 2013?
Mm-hmm.
Man. My life is a blink. What's happening here?
Fast.
It's the better part of a decade.
I mean, Ferris Bueller warned us about it.
That's true. We spoke of Grand Theft Auto, so of course we can't not speak of Red Dead Redemption, which now I haven't played 2 yet, but I feel like looking back, just the impact of 1 made more of a splash than 2. That's just me. I don't know.
Well, there was a zombie DLC.
That's true. That's true. But just the first time in that open world Western, do you like Red Dead 2 more than 1?
Do I like it more?
Because it's been over a year now.
It's a better story.
You think so?
It's a better story.
I mean, 1 was a good story, though.
Yeah, I'm not saying 1 wasn't a good story.
Yeah, it's a good story.
I know. I love it. And there's, man, it's so much bigger, too.
Really?
Yeah, the second one is a bigger game.
Wow.
Incredibly bigger.
It is getting late. I'm back there stretching. Talking off mic.
Oh, really? Tell me about it.
But I love why that's my biggest gaming mystery, why I haven't played Red Dead 2. I mean, the first one is in my top 10 games of all time.
My mystery is I don't know why I haven't seen Joker.
Weird, huh?
Yeah.
What's wrong with it? Or
I've seen Spies in Disguise.
A lot of movies you spoke of here.
Yeah,
you haven't seen Creed 2.
No, I haven't seen Creed
Drago's
two.
Back.
I haven't seen Whiplash.
you would love Whiplash.
I know I would love Whiplash.
Yeah, you would.
Yeah. I like J. Jonah Jameson.
Yeah. Say Joma.
J. Joma.
J. Stoma Jameson. The Battle Royale format is huge.
Mm.
You know, they have 100 people in the airplane, drop down, get your goodies, be the last man standing. Most people think we can't not speak of Fortnite.
Yeah.
It's huge. But I'm more of a PUBG guy, a player unknown's Battlegrounds. Love it.
This was really the decade of the major league gamer, too.
Right, yeah. The streamer's becoming, I mean, Ninja, you've even heard of, seen that guy. Now he has, costume accessories sold at Target where you can have his blue-dyed hair with his headband. It's crazy.
Yeah.
Crazy. Contracts were being exchanged from, he's used to be an exclusive Twitch streamer. Now he's on Mixer through Microsoft. This guy's getting paid millions to swap streaming services. That's where we are.
Right.
It's crazy.
Well, it's the era of the creator-owned content.
Yeah, yeah. You know. I can't imagine the taxes and legality going behind that whole thing. Can't imagine it.
What do you mean?
Like, how do you're creating laws and rules? Like, what's he being taxed for that guy that streams? He receives his income. Like, is there an LLC for that business he has? You think he has an LLC for his streaming business? Is that even a business? Or is that just him?
Well, it depends on...
I just wonder how that's
even
filed.
Are you just talking about the... Like,
this is so unentertaining adult talk, but I'm curious.
Yeah. I mean, I'm sure he's like basically an independent contractor, so he's fallen... you know, he's got to file... Like, all the donations and stuff, mm-hmm. he's got to stay on top of, and he has to report that.
I can't imagine. We're talking thousands, if not millions.
I'm surprised there hasn't been a big story come out where one of these internet sensation... millionaires hasn't been busted by the IRS yet.
But it's different
for not reporting everything.
If you're on YouTube, you have you know, you're sponsored. Every ad that is watched, I'm sure YouTube once a month gives you a big check. But
well, yeah, and then YouTube's going to report that, and then they're going to send you a statement.
But when you're on Twitch, you have, of course, people give big donations, but you have people throwing pennies your way.
Yeah.
Can you imagine keeping up with that?
Legally, I don't know how it works with the donation, since technically that's a donation. It's not a paid service, but you don't have to report any. Let's say you started a babysitting business. You wouldn't have to until one of your clients pays you over $500, you don't have to report it. So
I remember that.
Yeah. So I would guess there's a spreadsheet somewhere of donors with a running tab of how much that donor donates in a year. And if they ever go over the $500 mark, then you have to report that. But think of all the money you can make without having to report it.
Yeah.
I think I'm right about that.
He's not a professional.
I am not a financial lawyer.
Yeah.
But I just remember when I used to do radio remotes and we'd get paid talent fees for going and doing radio remotes, which is different because it was a service that we were providing to a business. Unless, you okay?
Mama mia, wow. I thought that was...
That was terrible.
I was far away and aimed... Okay.
I never had to report anything. And unless the client paid me over $500 in a year, I didn't have to report it.
Interesting.
Yeah.
So keep that in mind.
But if they did,
sure,
they would send me, you know, a form. Mm-hmm. What is it? I forget what it's called.
T2 Judgment Day form.
That's what it's called. A TWC.
I spoke of it before. You should play this. This is one game, maybe 6 hours long. What Remains of Edith Finch.
Yes, you have talked about this.
I'm telling you, that game messed me up in ways that didn't know I could be messed up. Play that if you can.
Is that the one Brooklyn started playing?
She beat it. She played it. Yeah. Yeah. I believe my 2012 game of the year, when we used to do those, would be Assassin's Creed 3. And I used to be a huge Assassin's Creed fan. So that was a big moment for me. And have you ever played those at all? Tried those now?
The first one.
I think you would like, you're a history guy. Yeah. You would like those.
I enjoyed the first one. I thought it was a lot of fun.
I can't go on and not speak of my beautiful BioShock Infinite.
Yeah.
I was a big fan. It was a big part of my decade as well.
Yeah. Big Daddy.
I'm finally getting back. I've dabbled in the Nintendo stuff with the Wii U, loving the Switch, of course. And Mario Kart 8 is top of the top as far as racing games go in that genre. And the last on my list here as far as games of the decade, I don't think you'll appreciate this, but Skyrim is on my list.
I tried, man.
I know. I did. Yeah. It was tough for me at first too. But you in general aren't that.
I don't like fantasy.
You don't like orcs and elves and knights, and you don't like that.
Well, it was also a big decade for you when it came to video card games.
How can I not speak of Hearthstone?
I know. That was a decade of Hearthstone.
Well, that was a close one.
I've been playing Hearthstone a decade, right?
2014. See, it's been 6 years. Yeah. You're right.
Yeah. I know.
Wow. I played it today. I play every single day. Every day. I play Hearthstone. It was funny the last time we recorded here. You're like, you guys still play that? And we're like, we were playing together 2 hours ago.
We're playing together right now.
You stopped it. What made you stop? You still want to hang with
the cool
kids? That's what's fun, is to kind of keep it rolling, baby.
Why did I stop?
I don't know.
I don't know either.
It was fun when you played.
I enjoyed it.
Yeah.
I don't know. I really enjoyed it.
Yeah,
I don't
you did.
Know why
you,
I stopped
You
playing.
Had a good hunter deck.
I did.
It's a good hunter deck.
What'd you call me? Fallout.
Yeah.
Fallout 4.
See, I was, yeah.
Game of the decade for me.
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
That's strong.
It is over your shoulder as we speak.
That's strong. Yeah, when did GTA 5, Fallout 4? I don't know. I can't decide.
Yeah.
They're both up there.
You're right. Yeah.
GTA 5 is over there somewhere.
Well, there's your special edition right behind the shoulder.
Yeah.
The room we have, have we ever described what's actually around us?
I mean, there's a couple of pictures.
Yeah, we have some comics on the wall, of course. The Foxglove Farm special. The Diablo
That's right. We are building up our listener collection here.
That's true. We have the Jar of Pickles, the Foxglove Farm Diablo tea. We have, of course, the Holiday Thanos, the Pac-Man machine, the Grand Theft Auto 5 special edition. A lot of stuff around here. A lot of things.
And there's a Ricky Martin CD in here.
Is there real? Uh-huh. Oh, yeah. You're right. You have any Chris Gaines over there? The Last Jedi of country albums?
No Chris Gaines.
Oh, you have the special edition glow-in-the-dark Skullface Madball.
I do.
Those are hard.
That was a gift from you.
Those are like one out of 20 to find, you know.
Yeah, I know.
Tough to get. Unless you know the little codes.
On the bottom?
Well, that and the blind bag itself had an imprinted code.
Oh, really?
Cheat and find out the code. I missed. That was a big thing for me. We're speaking like collectibles and things. My Madball collection came back into it. GPKs and Madballs, baby.
So I'm just curious.
Yeah.
I'm going to change subject here. We began this podcast in 2011. We say that often.
Correct.
What do you think we, and I have no idea what the answer is.
Yeah.
I haven't done the research. I don't know. What do you think the most often talked about topic is on this podcast?
Broad or specifically?
Specifically.
I think Marvel movies.
Way
that's
up
still,
there.
That still may be too broad, though.
Yeah.
I
would say Marvel.
Like the MCU. I think that was the main thing, I would say. But to be fair, that was a main part of the decade. It's hard to do a pop culture or geek culture show and not speak of that.
Yeah.
I'm not saying it's not our favorite thing.
I think pro wrestling's way up there.
We do bring it back with analogies quite often.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Did it last week with Rian Johnson and J.J. Abrams.
Yeah.
Didn't mean for it to happen. It just happened.
But it just happened. I love to play that Vince NWO promo any chance I get.
Really do. So yeah, the MCU or pro wrestling.
What do you think the most often, and not that I have access to it right now, what do you think, maybe we'll play it next time, the most often played, what is your favorite sound clips that we've had on the show?
Besides Drinkenstein? Anything Alex Jones is always good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Those are good.
Yeah.
Speaking of Skyrim.
Uh-huh.
The Macho Man Dragon.
Oh, of course. Yeah, yeah. It's a classic.
I was a big fan of, I don't even know if I still have the clip, but what movie was it? I don't even know the name of the movie. The actor, not Nick Nolte. That's all I can think of. The crazy actor. He was in Black Sheep.
Gary Busey?
Gary Busey.
Okay, okay.
And Gary Busey is doing that monologue about a chicken and using a chicken bone as a suppository.
Oh, yeah. What was that?
That might be one of my favorite sound clips.
Yeah. What was that from? Yeah. Weird. Weird. I totally forgot about that. What was that from?
I don't know.
Weird.
Wow. Yeah, the NASCAR prayer was pretty popular there for a minute.
That's true. Of course, Charlie Sheen.
Yeah. Yeah, Alex Jones may be my favorite.
I forgot about that suppository.
My favorite sound clip, the Alex Jones stuff. We haven't done that in a long time. We should bring back Alex Jones next time.
We should, yeah.
Like I said, I can't access it right now, but I'll forget to put it in. So we're not even going to pretend like I'm going to do it. Let's hear it right now. We can't.
And the, what's his name? Oh, man, the giggling CNN anchor.
Oh, Anderson Cooper.
Yeah, it's 1 a.m., so I'm losing memories here.
Giggling Anderson Cooper is really good.
It's a classic.
That's a strong one.
Yeah. Is it really 1 a.m.? Yeah. What happened to you?
I don't know. That went by real fast.
Whoops.
So any other video games?
That's all I have. I had pretty much a top 10 of each, like 10, you know, inspirational, influential, memorable things for me. And that was my top 10.
Rather than, I'm not going to play a bunch of songs, but I will go through the Billboard Best Performing Single and the Grammy Record of the Year for 2010 to 2019.
Okay.
You want to do that?
Yeah.
So think of music of 2010. Please feel free to try to guess even who the artist might be. Billboard's Best Performing Single of 2010.
Gaga? Is Gaga on there?
No.
What you got?
Kesha. TikTok.
Wow.
Don't Stop.
Wow. That's been 10 years?
I know. That was 10 years ago.
Wow.
The Grammy... Guess what the Grammy Record of the Year was?
What's that?
Use Somebody by Kings of Leon.
Wow, okay.
Use Somebody.
I thought that was earlier than that. That's weird. Huh.
2011, Billboard's Best Performing Single.
No clue.
Rolling in the Deep by Adele.
Okay.
That's a good one.
Yeah.
Grammy, Record of the Year Grammy.
What's that?
In 2011.
What was it?
Lady A, Need You Now. Lady Annabelle.
Oh, gross.
2012, Billboard's Best Performing Single.
Gaga?
Gautier, somebody that I used to know.
That was 7 years ago. Or 8 years ago at this point.
Yeah. Record of the Year Grammy was Rolling in the Deep by Adele.
I feel like that just came out.
2013, Billboard's Best Performing Single.
Gaga.
Macklemore and Lewis, Thrift Shop.
Wow.
Record of the Year Grammy, Somebody That I Used to Know by Gautier.
What? Well, yeah.
2014, Billboard's Best Performing Single.
Gaga.
Pharrell Williams, Happy. Record of the Year Grammy, Get Lucky, Daft Punk featuring Pharrell Williams. I can't believe this one is that old. Wow. 2015, Billboard's Best Performing Single.
What's that?
Uptown Funk.
Wow.
Mark Ronson and Bruno Mars. Yeah. Record of the Year Grammy was Stay With Me by Sam Smith.
Wow.
2016, Billboard's Best Performing Single.
I don't know.
Justin Bieber, Love Yourself.
Really? Huh.
Record of the Year Grammy, Uptown Funk. 2017, Billboard's Best Performing Single. It's just 2 years ago.
Hold on. I know that. I think more Bruno Mars, right?
Ed Sheeran.
Ah.
Shape of You.
Shape of You.
Record of the Year Grammy.
That was 2017?
That was 2017, yeah. Well, you got to think, I mean, Billboard's the entire year and the Grammy.
No, but like I thought that just came out recently.
Yeah, that was 2017. Record of the Year Grammy was Hello by Adele. 2018, Billboard's Best Performing Single.
I don't know.
God's Plan by Drake.
Ah.
Record of the Year Grammy winner, 24 Karat Magic.
That's what I was thinking.
Yeah. 2019, Billboard's Best Performing Single.
What's that?
Old Town Road.
Really? Wow.
Lil Nas X and Billy Ray Cyrus.
Wow.
Record of the Year Grammy for 2019.
Uh-huh.
This is America by Childish Gambino.
Huh. Yeah. So how are they judging these now?
What do you mean?
Is it still based off of sales?
Well,
because I would imagine the avenues they're pulling that from and the stats and everything's just kind of twisted.
Billboard is digital music, and it includes music streaming services, SoundCloud, Spotify, Apple Music, and Pandora Radio.
Wow.
All factored really into Billboard's best performing. So streams count. The Grammys is, it's a critical one.
Yeah.
So there's a
but they actually, like, when they talk about the charts and the sales, I mean, it's very.
Yeah.
Huh.
Yep. Wow. Well, there you have it. Media of the 2010s.
There you go.
You know, something we didn't mention. We did mention the creator created content, you know, hit an all-time high in the 2010s. I mean, like podcasts. But also, like, the cloud-based gaming became huge in 2010.
Yeah.
When you want to talk about video games.
For sure.
Because storage capacity came so, like, virtual storage capacity.
Uh-huh.
And server farms all over the place.
Yeah. I never would have thought my transition from physical gaming and hardware would go digital, but yeah. That's the way it is.
Yeah.
I pay $10 a month now for the Microsoft Game Pass, the Xbox Game Pass. It's the best thing I've ever done, gaming-wise.
It was also the decade of mobile gaming.
Oh, yeah.
But not necessarily, you know, it wasn't like a Sony Vita or whatever. It was your phone.
Right, yeah.
I mean,
yeah. It's huge.
I think the 2010s will be defined by the smartphone when we look back.
Probably so.
You know, when we're watching the best of the 2010s, it's all going to be about the smartphone.
Yeah.
Hey, let us know what your favorite video game, movie, TV show, or song of the 2010s were.
It's a lot of good media this decade. Hopefully more to come. But you look back on those lists, like, wow, it's a lot of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Good stuff.
You can let us know on Twitter at Adam and JP.
Of course, Facebook. Facebook.com/AdamandJP as well.
Or send us an email, adamandjp@gmail.com.
Oh, yeah.
I'm Jay Patrick. That's Adam.
You've been listening to the 2010s best of Podcast Roll, kind of.
What?
That doesn't make sense.
What? This is the best of Podcast Roll? Man. We must be really bad.
It's after 1 a.m.
We clawed, we chained our hearts in vain. We jumped, never asking why. We kissed, I fell under your spell. A love no one could deny. Don't you ever say, I just walked away. I will always want you. I can't live a life running for my life. I will always want you. I came in like a wrecking ball.
please try to chase me, but here's my number, so call me maybe. I wanna scream and shout and let it all out, and scream and shout and let it out. We sing oh we oh we oh we oh, we sing oh we oh we oh we oh we oh we oh we oh. Now you're just somebody that I used to know. Now you're just somebody that I used to know. It's going down, hey! I'm yelling timber. You better move, you better dance. Let's make a night you won't remember. I'll be the one you won't forget.
I'm sexy and I know it. Look at that body.
He's sexy and he knows it.
I wear your granddad's clothes. I look incredible. I'm in this big old coat from that thrift shop down the road.
Hey, he wears your granddad's clothes.
That's right.
He looks incredible.
I do.
He's in that big old coat.
It's from
that thrift shop down the
road. Hey, let's go. I'm gonna pop some tags. Only got $20 in my pocket. I'm hunting, looking for a come up.
This is super awesome.
The sun. I'm up all night to get some. She's up all night for good fun. I'm up all night to get lucky.
We're up all night till the sun. We're up all night to get some. We're up all night for good fun. We're up all night to get lucky. We're up all night to get lucky. We're